Welcome to this Q&A session on IIFT. IIFT is the second of the exams, the MBA exams for this season. And it is the first of the paper-based exams, the other two being SNAP and SAT. So, what is this session going to be about? Since we have only 2 or 3 days left for IIFT now, what I'll do is I'll not give you too much gyan on what are the chapters you should read right away and stuff like that. The way I'm going to handle this session is that it's meant to be a Q&A session on IIFT. So, I'll tell you in brief about the paper format. Till then, you guys can think about your questions and start typing in the questions next to the screen that you see. As soon as I start getting these questions, I'll try and answer them chronologically or where I can combine these questions. So guys, first, just answer one question from my end. Can all of you hear me properly? A few of you can type yes in case y'all are able to hear me. Guys, can you hear me? Okay, great, great. Okay, guys, a lot of yeses have come in. So, till the time you think about your questions, let me give a brief intro to this exam. As you know, it is conducted for both campuses of IIFT, that is Delhi and Kolkata. The exam typically has 6 sections, but it is disguised as an exam with 4 sections. Historically, this has been the trend in IIFT. Earlier in 2011 and 12, they used to have only 4 sections. Then, okay, Mansi says my voice is breaking. Mansi, can you hear me clearly now? So, IIFT used to have 4 sections earlier. DILR, VARC, QA and GK. Since the last 3 to 4 years, what they have done is that certain sections are split into 2 parts. So there is a part A and a part B. The typical breakup is VA and RC are one part, DI and LR are one part. So that is something you should be prepared for. Generally, the way we prepare for DILR is that we practice one of the two, or we are stronger in one of the two, and we try to solve that more. Whereas in IIFT, as I will show, you need to be prepared for both of these sections. Last year, DI was clubbed with quant and LR was a separate section altogether. Now just imagine if you would have practiced for only DI, then you would have been able to solve the DI and QA section very well. But your entire LR would have gone for a toss. The year before that, I was clubbed with LR and quant was a separate. So every year you will see that IIFT. Let me give you a very brief overview of all 6. Let me start with quant. Typically the quant section in IIFT. Question. But the challenge that you face, these are a long story. What you should do is go back and look at not only the mocks that you've practiced, but also the actual IIFT papers from 2015, 14, 13, etc. You will find that in specific cases like CERTs or logs, you have direct questions. Otherwise, questions on time distance, time work, numbers, etc., are all given in a kind of a story format. So you will have a story of 3-4 lines and then you need to figure out that this is a time and distance question. This is a question of numbers. So quant becomes a challenging section mainly because of this one point. Here your application skills come into play. Are you able to decipher the question and understand what is the topic being addressed? However, you can always well in IIFT. The questions are simpler. So that is one thing you need to keep in mind. typically you have 20 questions. Here I digress for 1 minute and tell you that in IIFT, every section has different marks. So for example, GK might have only half a mark per question. Quant might have 1 mark per question. Some other section might have 0.75 marks per section and so on. So it all depends on. After quant, the second section that we need to consider is DI. DI is typically the section in IIFT which most students are scared of. This is because IIFT DI is, it has its own style. What they will do is there will be an entire table of, let's say, 8 countries and they are exports to 10 different countries. So there will be a huge table with numbers in millions of dollars or billions of rupees. And the questions will involve a lot of calculations. So for instance, there might be a table on India's exports to 10 different countries, and you will have those exports for 7 years. And they might say, for which of these years was India's growth highest? Now, it's a very easy question to understand. This is the challenge in DI. The questions are easy to understand. However, the calculations are very time consuming. Last year, there were 3 sets in DI of 5 questions each. One was a complicated, I think it was 2 graphs and 1 table. One was based on 3 tables, which looked very difficult, but which was easy. And one was based on 2 pie charts, which was complicated. So that way, there will be a mix of easy and tough questions. The challenge is to identify, out of those 3 or 4 sets that you get in DI, which is the one that you definitely need to attempt, and among the other sets, which are the questions that you can solve using elimination. One point that I have in papers is that a lot of these questions where calculation is high can be solved using elimination of answer options. But for IIFT DI elimination, you need to be good at concepts like averages and ratio proportion. Especially you need to know how to compare fractions, because in a lot of cases they'll ask you to compare percentage growth. That I'll discuss is LR. Typically IIFT has a collection of different puzzles. You will always have 1 to 2 sets on arrangements, which could be linear, circular, multiple row, rectangular, or multiple parameter complex arrangements. Then you have a lot of miscellaneous puzzles. So you have completer series, coding, decoding, family relationships, direction-based questions, puzzles, syllogisms, etc. But last year, the LR section was the easiest section of the entire paper. You could have attempted each and every question in that paper or in that section and really increased your score in IIFT. Of course, one way to compensate that, they had reduced the marks for each question in LR. So I think there were only 0.5 or 0.75 marks for LR last year for each question. But it is something that you should definitely attempt. Never leave LR in IIFT. The next 2 sections I will typically treat together, as I have written here, RC and VA have traditionally been 2 subsections. IIFT RC generally are very long. So you will have more than 1,000-word passages, 1,200-word passages. They are typically related to current affairs, things happening around you. So read up a lot on what are the things happening around you and have opinions on that. That will help you solve IIFT RC. The questions generally are much more factual in nature compared to, say, a CAD or a ZAT. So RC, again, you don't need to attempt all the sets in all the RC passages for the sectional cutoff. The VA section in RC or in IIFT has a mix of vocabulary, grammar, fill in the blanks, jumbled sentences, etc. There you can take a call based on your strengths and weaknesses. There, I may not be able to tell you attempt this definitely or attempt that definitely, because it keeps. Finally, coming to GK, as I have written here, GK is always a separate section, so it has the least marks per question, generally 0.5.
you don't need to attempt all the questions in GK. Even if you get single figure marks, you should be able to clear the GK cutoff. Some of the easiest questions in IIFT GK, and IIFT is the only exam which has this type of question, are matched up column questions. So they might give you, let's say, 5 CEOs and 5 companies. You don't need to know all 5 CEOs. Even if you are able to identify one and match him correctly, you'll be able to eliminate a couple of answer options. Since IIFT only has 4 options, answer elimination is a very, very critical strategy in IIFT. Having looked at section-wise strategies, I'll just give you a couple of pointers right away. One, as I said, IIFT has different marks per section. What I have seen students do is that they try and attempt those sections first where the marks per question are highest. This is not necessarily the best strategy. You should go with the section where you are good. IIFT is a 2-hour exam, so you anyways have limited time. So for the first 1.5 hours or 1 hour 40 minutes, focus on those sections where you are damn good. In the last half an hour, you can focus on the 1 or 2 sections that you have left. Keep that in mind. Secondly, the cutoffs in IIFT are within a section, not within a subsection. So if DI and LR are together, then you will have DI-LR cutoffs. You will not have separate DI cutoffs and separate LR cutoffs. Please do not assume that DI and LR will always be part of the same section. Similarly, please do not assume that RC and VA will be part of the same section. So you cannot afford to be weak in the exam. Okay. There have been 1 or 2 past IIFT papers where there have been 6 sections. Now the trend is there are 4 sections, but 2 of those sections will have part 1, part 2. But be prepared that you can get 4 sections or you can get 6 sections. I have now started getting some questions. So let me start answering a few of those questions. Okay. So there is a question from Mansi. Are there sectional cutoffs? Adarsh has the same question. A lot of people have ask this question, are there sectional cutoffs? Yes, there are sectional cutoffs. I will repeat the point that I had just made. Typically, IIFT has 4 sections. I will again list down the sections. Quant is generally one section. DI and LR are 2 parts of one section, which means they are divided into part 1, part 2. VA and RC are divided into part 1 and part 2 within the overall verbal section. And GK is a separate section. So in spite of technically speaking there being 6 sections in the exam, you will only have 4 sectional cutoffs. So keep that in mind. You will not have 6 sectional cutoffs unless they are specifically mentioned. So read the instructions given on the first page before you start the exam. What I am saying right now or what any other expert will tell you today will be based on last year's IIFT. You should, when you go to the center, you should read the first page of your question booklet very thoroughly, understand how the paper has been divided and then start solving, then make a strategy. Don't blindly follow whatever we are saying. So, Mansi, okay, Sanika has a question, minimum questions to be answered to minimum questions to be answered to clear the sectional cutoff. Sanika, no fixed value as such because every year the difficulty level of each section. What you should keep in mind is historically IIFT has always expected you to have a non-negative score in each section. So I would say that for each subsection, means you consider it as 6 different sections only, for each subsection try and get a score above 0. Automatically that will ensure that you clear the sectional cutoff. If you get a score of 20 in quant and don't score in say GK, then you are not going to clear the sectional cutoff. So I can't give you a minimum number of questions, but you should try and get a non-zero, non-negative score somewhere around 6, 7, 6, Even if you get a score of 7 in each section, you are getting 42. 42 typically has helped clear cutoffs. Last year, the cutoff was higher because of the easy LR. Manish has a question, where can I get current affairs from IIFT? Okay, Manish, IIFT has a mix of static and dynamic data. So one thing I would definitely suggest is that you should spend these next couple of days solving the actual IIFT paper from 2011 to 15 and get a hang of what the GK has been. There are generally around 25 to 28 questions in the IIFT GK, of which 4 to 5 are always table-based questions. These are easily answered. Plus, there will be anywhere close to 10 to 12 questions which will be based on current affairs. So you can refer to any material that helps you prepare for bank exams or for, let's say, SAT, where you can get Indian business and corporate, Indian economy, socio-political affairs, etc. Anything happening around you for the last 6 months, try and revise those current affairs, you should be able to do well in IIFT. Plus, there are always some strategic questions which will depend on your overall general knowledge. Suyash's question is, how to tackle time in IIFT to clear the overall cutoff? Okay, Suyash, what I typically do is, anyways, you cannot adopt my strategy blindly because I go with a different objective in mind. But what I typically do is I attempt the TI and LR section first when I am at my freshest. This is mainly because I come back to office and do a thorough analysis of DI, LR, quant, etc. That is why. Of course, I don't expect you to do that. But what you can do is start off with DI and LR because they are generally on the tougher side or more time-consuming side. So don't keep it for the end. And dedicate roughly 45 minutes for these two sections. After that, based on your comfort level on in maths vis-a-vis English and RC, you can devote half an hour or 25 minutes each for the two sections. Generally, I have observed that the verbal section in IIFT does not take too much time. I am able to finish off verbal in IIFT. I am not talking about RC, I am talking about verbal. I am able to finish off verbal in anywhere between 10 to 15 minutes. So I keep another 15 minutes for 2 RC passages. So I keep 45 minutes to 1 hour for DI, 50 minutes for DILR, 30 minutes for verbal. Then I quickly solve GK, jitna mujhe aata hai, whatever I can answer in 10 minutes, and keep the last half an hour per point. So that is how I divide my paper. You will have to figure out the sequence based on your strengths and weaknesses. So that is my suggestion for everybody. I would typically say start with TI or LR based on how strong you are. If you feel you are pathetic in that area or you are not good in that area, then don't start there. Then start with English or quant. That is entirely up to you. Okay. What sections are clubbed together and how do you know what how the questions are or how the sections have been clubbed? Shashwat, that is typically given on the first page of the exam paper that you get. So when you get the question paper in your hand, you would have written section 1, part 1, so many questions, part 2, so many questions, but they don't give you the section name. So as soon as the invigilator tells you that you can start answering your paper, you open, go to that section, check part 1, part 2, and then only you will come to know. Generally, as I have been saying all the time, VARC are together, DILR are together, but there has been 1 year when DI was clubbed with quant and LR was separate. There has been 1 year when DI was clubbed with LR, quant was separate. So, I cannot guarantee you and you should not go with preconceived notions. Rather, prepare for all six and then take it as it comes. Prudhvi has a question, where can I learn verbal ability for IIFT? Prudhvi, at this stage I would say don't focus on learning verbal ability. To try and solve the verbal section for the last 5 years mocks at 2011 to 15 and then you can take a couple of mocks in conditions where you try and solve verbal plus RC in half an hour. That will really tell you how prepared you are. But otherwise, because at this stage you will not be able to focus too much on vocabulary or learning new tricks. At the most, if you want, you can go and revise your concepts of grammar and practice a few jumbled sentences and fill in the blanks. But otherwise, verbal is so vast that in 2 days or 3 days, now you will not have enough time to really learn verbal. Mansi's question is the difficulty level almost same in IIFT as DI and quant seem to be tough? Mansi, DI in IIFT is tough, accept that, because it is very time consuming. So you will need to identify which is the set that you can solve, and then you will need to practice that as much as you can. So out of 15 to 18 questions that you get in DI, you need to attempt 9 to 10 questions, around 2 sets, that is more than enough. Okay, others wants me to repeat the time allocated to each section. Others, I will repeat that time, but this is based on my experience, so I will put a disclaimer right away. Please do not blindly follow it. Go with your strengths only. I allocate 50 minutes, 50, for DI and LR combined. I allocate 25 minutes for English and RC combined, 10 minutes for GK. So you can take English and verbal and RC to half an hour, 10 minutes for GK, and 30 minutes for quant. Typically, see, you divide 2 hours into 4 parts. So you divide verbal and quant equally, 30-30. Usme plus minus 5 ho sakta hai based on your strength. Between DILR and GK, keep minimum time for GK, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, again depends on your strength in DILR. So that is the kind of breakup that I would insist on. But please adapt it as per your capability. A lot of questions, a lot of people have this question on GK, how to clear it at this time. How to prepare for GK this time. So I will say this again, in GK, focus on a lot of current affairs, read up on incidents and events that have happened in the last, focus on incidents and events that have happened in the last 6 months. Areas that you need to look at are sports, awards, economics, politics, trade, business and corporate, international organizations, international happenings, etc. The IIFT GK is not very difficult. Assuming you have anywhere between 25 to 28 questions, please understand that you don't need to attempt all. Even if you are able to attempt anywhere, say, between around 14 questions, and you get half of them right, because each question has 0.5. So out of 14, even if you get 10 or 12 right, you will get close to 5 to 6 marks. There will be some loss due to negative marking in the 1-2 that you get wrong. But a score of 5 or 6 in IIFT make you sail through the cutoff. Don't try to attempt questions that you don't know. In the 10 minutes that I have allocated for IIFT GK, even if you are able to attempt 10 questions perfectly, that's enough. You can always come back in the last 1 or 2 minutes and answer a few more questions there. In the last couple of minutes, you can't target any other section. GK kar hi sakte ho. Vidaksha has a question, any specific news for this year, as in which section is going to be easy or hard? Vidaksha, no news. And frankly, if somebody tells you, I would say, okay, accept it, listen to it, but don't take it too much too hard, because IIFT has this nasty habit of throwing surprises each year. So there have been one or two DI sections which have been terrible even for people like us, one or two LR sections which have been very easy. You could end up getting a lot of surprises. So aap us se mat prepare ki. Shashwat has a question, I am asking if you strategize cutoff clearance, how do you know you are safe? Okay Shashwat, the basic thumb rule, as I said, you work backwards. Let's say you want to target a score of 45 in the exam, and you have 6 small sections, quant, DI, LR, verbal, RC, GK. So you want to target a score of 48, then you need to get 8 marks in each section. Then work backwards from there as to how many attempts I get each. Now obviously your GK cutoff can't be 8. There the cutoff will be hardly 2 or 3 marks or 4 marks. So GK meant you need to target somewhere around a score of 5 or 6. The cutoff in LR, if it is easy, is going to be much higher. It will be somewhere around say 10. So wahan pe us hisab se attempts karne padenge. So in each section, you will need to strategize your attempts based on how many marks have been allocated per question and what is the difficulty level of that section that year. So there are two variables here, and in the absence of any data on these variables right now, I can't really tell you that you do exactly do this or exactly do that. But historically, whatever I've seen in IIFT, on that basis I'll tell you, LR, try and score as much as possible, it will increase your overall score. DI, try and do 1.5 to 2 sets out of 3. Agar 4 sets diye hai, so try and do 2 to 2.5 sets. RC, if you have 3 passages, do properly. Verbal, whatever is the number of questions, anywhere between 60 to 70% of those attempts. Quant, again depending on number of questions, 60 to 70% of those attempts. That should easily help you clear the cutoff in IIFT. Sanika has a question. What if, how about only 6 or 7 questions of GK with accuracy? Sanika, that might be too close. So it might really become a cut-to-cut thing to attempt only 6 to 7 questions. I would say 10 to 12 questions is really important. Shibashish has a question, I am good in LR, not very great in DI. How should I place the paper? Complete LR and then move to English font, or should I? Shibashish, if you are not very good at DI, then don't do it right away. Finish LR, finish English and font. I would say even give 10 minutes for GK and then do DI in the last 30 minutes. Because then anyways in DI you will need to target 1 to 1.5 sets. So don't do DI initially. Okay, Mansi, Damanji, 2-3 people have this question. My quant is not very strong. How should I prepare? Okay, so quant, as I said, are story based questions in the sense that you will have questions which are given. That is because the question you realize that all you need to do was calculate the number of factors. So, in quant, you will need to practice understanding what the question is asking for. You don't need to solve all questions together. You don't need to even answer them in sequence. Once you start scanning through the paper, you will find there are some questions which are straight away sitters. And IIFT does have a number of sitters. What I would suggest, if you want to practice this, what I would suggest is open last year's paper, try and identify the sitters, and then open last year's analysis that we have provided and see if it correlates. If you are able to identify even half the sitters that we have mentioned, then you know that you are on the right track. So that way you can actually practice quant and verb. 2 or 3 people are saying can we skip DI altogether. It is a very risky strategy, because if quant and LR get clubbed and DI comes separately, then you are badly done. I mean, then you are dead. If DI comes separately, you are absolutely dead. You don't have to be afraid of DI. Remember that a lot of people are afraid of IIFT DI. Ye bahut difficult hota hai, is there. Yes, all of that is true. But nobody is asking you to solve all 3 sets. Trust my reputation on this and state it and say, you don't need to solve all the 3 or 4 sets. 1 to 1.5 to 2 sets is more than sufficient. But 2 or 3 people again have this question. Any specific news for this year? What will be easy or hard? I'll repeat my. We cannot say this. Shazmin, you've been asking this question again. What section up together? So I'll say this again. Typically, DILR are together, VARC are together. But there is no guarantee for the same. Okay, Prachi's question and Prithvi's question is the paper going to get tougher than the previous year? What is the cutoff? Or if the paper is going to get tougher than the previous year? Prithvi, the lowest cutoff that I have seen for IIFT is 38. That was some 3 years ago when the paper was really tough. So that is why I typically say try and target 42 to 45. More or less, you should be done. Of course, last year, even in 48. So again, that is something. 45 plus is generally a very safe score, but that depends on the. Anurag's question is some tips for RC. Okay, Anurag, IIFT generally has a lot of factual questions. But it's more like finding a needle in a haystack because they are very long passages. So you need to read the passage, spend some time on it, and go back and find the RC, the data for that RC question. So for IIFT, what I would suggest is you read the passage thoroughly in the first attempt itself, and then try to identify the correct data from the question. Generally, my strategy is to skim through the passage quickly, look at the question, and go back to the passage. But in IIFT, it is not possible to read the passage twice within the same, you know, within such a short period. So there I would suggest that you read it thoroughly the first time itself and then try and answer the question. Typically, one or two RC passages again are very doable. One is very difficult, one is moderate. The key is to identify those passages. If you can attempt the two easy ones or the two easy to moderate ones, again, you should be able to clear the cutoff. Prachi's question is how to maximize IIFT score, what should be the target score? So Prachi, I just said 42 to 45, again depending on the difficulty level. I'll repeat one point for the benefit of everybody. In LR, if it is as per last year's difficulty level, try and attempt everything. DI, if you have 3 sets, then anywhere between 1.5 to 2 sets. If you have 4 sets, so 2 to 2.5 sets. Verbal, 70% of the section at least, with very good accuracy. Of course, I can't compromise on accuracy. Quant, 70%. GK, at least 50% of the questions, 45 to 50% of the questions. What else is left? RC, if you have 3 RCs, then 1.5 to 2 RCs. Shibashish asked, if DI and LR are merged, then can we solve all LR questions and leave the DI section? Yes, Shibashish, you can do that. But I would say don't rely only on that. If they are merged, if you can solve everything in LR, gladly go ahead and do it. But don't leave DI just because you... There might be a set which is very easy and there might be a set in LR which is very difficult. Last year, there was a set on complex arrangements in LR, which was, I would say, difficulty level very tough. I mean, just to tell you, I have been an LR faculty for 10 years and it took me nearly 25 minutes to solve that question in the exam scenario. Now, I had nothing to lose. You can go up and look last year's IIFT paper. There was this set on various hostels, if I remember correctly, and people in those hostels. I didn't have anything to lose, so I was doing it more like a challenge. But just imagine, yes, I spent just doing one set in IIFT and then you're banking only on LR, then you will really feel, you know, your scores will go for a toss. Praveen's question is IIFT similar to GMAT? No. Praveen, IIFT is not similar to GMAT at all. So if you are preparing for GMAT, the theory might remain more or less the same, but you will need to practice IIFT mocks and at least look at last year's paper to get a grasp of what IIFT is all about. Prachi asks, is the cutoff applied to subparts? No, Prachi, the cutoff does not apply to subparts. If BA, combined cutoff, you don't have separate cutoff. Shashwat's question is, Rajiv has a similar question. Any strategy for RC picking because they all seem to be? Rajiv asked, how many RCs? As I said, if there are 4 RCs, then you need to pick two at least. What is the strategy? Well, Shashwat, look at what the topics of the answer, and then look at the question. Some questions will clearly be factual in nature, whereas there will be some RCs where all the questions are inferential in nature. One of the tricks that IIFT adopts is that the simplest of the topics, I mean something which is very easy to read, also has very difficult questions. And sometimes some topic, let's say they are talking about liquidity ratios and financial terms, so it might look very intimidating to students, but all the questions might be very factual in nature. So there is no fixed formula, but look at the kind of topics that are given. Obviously, one or two more will be more comfortable for you. One or two will be very scary for you. So the ones that you're comfortable, you see questions, look at what questions have been asked there, and then you will have to plunge into it. There is no fixed strategy. You will have to plunge into it, start answering the questions, then you will come to know. Even if you are able to attempt one or two questions in that, it's okay. Okay. Somebody has a question, what will be a better option now, taking mocks or practicing previous year's paper? At this stage, either of the two won't make a difference. You can take anything. What you can do is take one mock, take one actual paper. That might be a better strategy than taking only mocks or only actual paper. Karan again asking, Karan, I got your question, that is it alright to attempt two out of four RCs? Yes, Karan, it is perfectly okay to attempt two out of four RCs, provided you attempt them fully. Then in the third and fourth RC, you can read them and you will find that one or two questions in those RCs are also doable. So that way, you will end up attempting 2.5 RCs actually. Sameer, I answered this question 2 or 3 times, but for your benefit, I'll say this one last time now. What? How to allot time for each section? I'll say it very quickly. I allocate 30 minutes for VARC, 30 minutes for POND, anywhere around 50 minutes for DI and LR combined, and 10 minutes for GA. That is my breakup. Okay, Lovelace has a question, how to prepare oxymoron for VA? Lovelace, that is a very, very technical question. For this, you will have to go back to your Renan Martin or whatever grammar book that you have been given by your institute or wherever you are preparing for, and read up more on oxymoron. That is the only way to prepare for that, because it is a very small subpart of figures of speech which appears in RC or in VA. So I would not really, at this stage, I would not really bother too much about it, but even if you feel you're weak, go back to Renan Martin or a standard grammar book and prepare from there. Okay, I guess I have picked most of the questions that were to be answered. Let me just see if, yeah, so Samir's is the last question that I have got so far. Yeah, Karan again has a question, same for DI as well. Yes, Karan, you're perfectly right. Half of the DI sets, so there are 4 sets, try to attempt 2. In the remaining 2 sets, it is okay if you attempt 1 or 2 questions. Okay guys, one small tip here, in DI, very often what happens is there are 4 questions in that set. The set is doable, but one set, one question in that set is a terror question, where you might have to do 10 calculations. So it is absolutely okay if you leave that question even if the set is very easy, because you are losing out on time. There you might be able to eliminate 1 or 2 options, then you can make an educated guess. But in DI, half of the sets or 2 sets, and then anything else you can attempt. So guys, any more questions from your end? Okay, so I'll just repeat some of the points that I had made for people who logged in late, and I'll summarize everything. IIFT has 4 sections, which is two of which are subdivided into two parts for a total of six. While preparing, even now, I would say focus as if there are six sections only, so that you don't get caught unawares if there are any surprises. Each section will have different marks, questions. So again, don't go with preconceived. Whatever. Try and score a non-negative score, means 5, 6, 7, whatever, in each subsection. Try and make it your aim to score that much, and you'll be able to clear the sectional cutoff. Allocate half an hour each to quant and verbal, 50 minutes to DI, 10 minutes to GK. You can start with DI if you are comfortable with it. If you're not, then you can leave it for the end. And yeah, that's about it. GK, in GK, try and attempt half the questions, because you will be able to easily clear the cutoff. I will myself be appearing for, okay, Puneet has come back. Please give some advice for verbal. So Puneet, as I have been saying all along, in RC, you will have four RCs in the section. They are typically long, but the questions are factual in nature. So you should try and attempt two out of those four RCs. In the remaining two, you can attempt one or two questions that you are comfortable with. In verbal, you will have all kinds of questions like fill in the blanks, grammar, vocabulary. Whatever you can attempt, give it your best shot. Right now, you can't learn verbal. You will have to practice from the mock or from last year's. So, as I was saying, Sunday I will also be appearing for IIFT. It is possible that in case some of you are in Mumbai, we might end up at the same center. But my purpose of taking IIFT is not to clear it, so don't worry, I will not be eating anybody's seat. I have cleared the IIFT cutoff consistently for the last 6 years. But be rest assured that I don't go and take the GDPI, so I won't eat up your seat. It's just that I will be using that to provide the IIFT answer key. They will be providing you the IIFT score calculator and answer key on Sundays. So you can log into the website at 3:30 onwards, and from 4 o'clock onwards, we'll actually start providing the answer key as an instant. Ready by evening, you should be able to check your tentative scores. Okay, Vedaksha has a question again. What exactly to refer from past paper? Vedaksha, you when you are looking at a past paper, you don't need to look at the exact question per se, because the question might not get repeated. You need to look at the style of the question. That okay, IIFT, if you see DI for instance, you'll find that there are a lot of questions on percentage growth. There are a lot of questions on what is the second highest value of this or second lowest value of this. Those kind of questions. If you see LR, you will find that you always have one set on arrangement, which is difficult but doable. So you can time consuming, really speaking. So those kind of trends you need to start seeing and identify that typically these are the kind of questions which I am able to solve. These are the kind of questions that I am not able to solve. Rajiv's question is, can you suggest some areas of GK that will help in last minute preparation? Rajiv, take the last 5 IIFT papers, practice the tabular questions. I can't guarantee that you'll get tabular questions, but practice them as much as you can. That's point one. Point two is, focus on current affairs of the last 6 months from areas like trade, economy, business, politics, finance, sports, awards, etc. Rohan, what should be the nominal schedule for the last 3 days? Well, Rohan, you need to practice one mock at least and try out one actual paper. Do it from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. so that you practice sitting for 2 hours in one sitting and practicing the paper then. In terms of revision, just look at those areas where you feel you are relatively weak. So, I will be back on Sunday preparing your answer key and giving you your score. As I said, you can log in at 3:30 onwards. We also have a chat from an expert from ITM for preparation of last minute preparation tips on CAT. That is scheduled for Friday, 25th November at 4 p.m. Just go on the website and check the link, and you can chat with the lady there at Friday. As far as IIFT is concerned, I guess I've tried to answer all your doubts. Please feel free to come back to us if you have further doubts. Feel free to log in and check out your scores on. And do participate in the ITM chat on 25th November at 4 p.m. Thanks. And wish you all the best.